name's William Fitzpatrick, W-I-L-L-I-A-M-F-I-T-Z-P-A-T-R-I-C-K. I'm a lieutenant colonel in the United States Air Force Auxiliary, which is Civil Air Patrol, and I'm a squadron commander and one of the lead balloon instructors for the lighter-than-air program at New Mexico has.
Let's just wait for the bells. Okay, awesome. So, why are you here today?
So, we came down here for doing a STEM outreach program, the ability to get into the community and talk about what aviation does for our communities. It's one of those secrets, unfortunately, that we don't talk about every day. But being able to talk to youth and other individuals about the importance of aviation and what that brings to our communities is incredibly important.
It's the Aggie fight song. We'll have to wait for this to go.
Does that play every day?
At noon.
Oh, wow. Okay. I guess we'll just wait for that to pass a little bit and then we'll continue because that's going to make it difficult. Okay. Wow, that's cool. Okay. I'm sorry, could you tell me again, like, why we're here?
Okay, so we're doing a STEM community outreach program. The Air Force Auxiliary and Civil Air Patrol, we want to talk about general aviation in our communities, and one of our congressionally chartered aspects and what we're supposed to be doing is fostering general aviation within our communities. Unfortunately, it's something that's not very easy to convey to people who live out in the general public. You can't take an airport and plop it in the middle of a place and say, here, this is what aviation is about, even though it's something that affects us on a day-to-day basis. So if you have any type of shipping program that you order online, you probably expect your delivery to get there within 2 days. It doesn't do that without having the advent of aviation. And that's a type of transportation that really is about the ability of expenditure and expedience. So I can take products from across the globe, and now the world has become your marketplace. Unfortunately, within the next 10 to 15 years, we're going to be in a shortfall of 250,000 pilots and about 250,000 technicians. It's a strategic thing, too. We're seeing it not just within our civilian sector, but we're also seeing it strain on our national defense side with our pilots within the United States Air Force and our sister branches. And so this is something that we need to talk about and get youth involved in, maybe not to go to the military, but have an understanding that there are career fields out there that they can get involved with in aviation, be that a technician, be that the people who are maintaining and taking care of the aircraft, the pilots themselves who fly it, airport managers and other crews that make this system work. And if you think of aviation, an airport and airplanes, it's a transit system. So your airport is your on-ramp, and without those functioning, you don't have this highway in the sky. So what we do is we brought out the glider today and we brought out our hot air balloon. Both of those we can solo cadets at 14 years old if they get the proper training. And they can get private pilot certificates at 16 years old. And what we're trying to do is show that even though most people wouldn't think of a 16-year-old or a 14-year-old, nobody lets a 14-year-old drive their car. But we'll let a 14-year-old who shows that they're competent and have the ability to take an aircraft by themselves after the proper training.
So do you guys see this like help get people into like aviation?
The program itself is definitely something that helps people get into aviation. We've sent people both to the civilian sector who have gotten either their foot into aviation through Civil Air Patrol, or we've also sent them to the military. I was a cadet prior, I joined the United States Air Force, and now I work for the state with the aviation division. At the same time, we have cadets that are now at the United States Air Force Academy, the United States Naval Academy, and other colleges across the United States, and they're concentrating in a science, technology, or engineering mathematics group.
Okay. So we see like a lack of like women in STEM. Are you guys doing anything to
Yes, so a huge aspect. And I'm very blessed in the fact that that was something that I never even thought was an issue. And unfortunately, when I got older, I learned that it was an issue. But I was surrounded when I was 15 years old. My cadet flight staff, my bosses per se, that were other cadets my same age, they were all female officers, cadet officers, and they were all had their solar certificates, getting ready to get their pilot certificates. And so out of 15 of us who were going to flight school at the time, 7 of those individuals were female. So to me, I never saw the correlation. It wasn't until I got older that I saw that it's only about 3% to 5% within the aviation community is female. And that's a huge aspect of it's not something that should be there in place. Women have every bit the same right and the same ability and the same competencies to be able to fly. And I've been able to know a lot of women who have an incredible skill set and be able to take on that same field and aspirations.
Awesome. What made want to fly?
I think that's a lifelong dream. I don't think there's a human being out there who hasn't looked skyward before and said, what if I could fly? That's an adage that's probably as old as time itself. The difference for me was I got involved in a program like this that gave me the opportunity to be around aircraft and see aircraft and then eventually fly those aircraft. And really, this is a gateway. This is a bridge. And you have senior members and officers and our Air Force colleagues from the active duty, the guard, and the reserve side that also reach across and say, let's build that bridge for others so they have an understanding on how to get there and where to go and help them fulfill their same dreams.
So it seems like it's like a lot of work that goes into like putting all of these things together. Mm-hmm. Why do you guys do that?
For me, it's self-fulfillment. Every single person here is a volunteer. So the unfortunate thing is it's not a paid gig. It is something that you come out and you volunteer your time and your effort for. But it's something I think most of us, at least that are already involved in the aviation community, they see a need for. And because of that, we're willing to come out and spend that time to go out and do outreach because it's something that is near and dear to our hearts. And we want to share that same gift. We want to be able to